salvation, for the hope of our present future, for the ability to access your presence, for the confidence I have in you that you are my God. Give him the glory this morning. Give him the praise. Oh God, we praise you. We bless you. We magnify you this morning because you are our God. Oh, we praise your name. You have done us good, Lord. For your protection, we say thank you. For your provision, we say thank you. For your compassion that fills us, we say thank you. For your mercies, we say thank you. For the forgiveness of sins, we say thank you. For the hope that we have in you, we say thank you. For the name of Jesus in our mouth, we say thank you. For your word in our heart, we say thank you. For the gift of fellowship, we say thank you. We are grateful to you, our King and our Lord. You are the Almighty. You are our strength. Our refuge, you are our pillar. We bless you, Jesus. We bless you, Jesus. We honor you today. We give you praise. Our God, we are grateful for all you have done, for all you will do, for all that you are doing. We thank you, Lord, because you are the God who answers prayer. And we are grateful that your love for us is a part of it. We thank you, Lord, because in you we overcome our being. And our heart rejoices, O Lord, because of your grace and your kindness, because of your love and your compassion, because of your peace and your goodness. Oh, we praise you, Lord. We praise you, Lord. We praise you, Lord. We have a shadow of you. We say thank you, Father. Holy Spirit, we are grateful for your presence. This morning, we need to pray to God. Pray that the Holy Spirit will pass by your way. Pray that the Holy Spirit will pass by your way. Pray that the Spirit of life will pass by your way. Pray that the Lord will reach out unto you this morning, because His presence is here. Just like the woman with the issue of blood, as power came forth out of the body of Christ, pray that the power of the Lord will reach out unto you this morning. Pray that the Lord will bless you by His Spirit. Pray that every problem will be solved to you. Pray that the mountains before you will be made low. Pray that your valleys will be filled up. Even in the name of Jesus, His presence is here with us. His glory is here with us. And His compassion is here with us. Oh, Father, let your glory reach out to each one of us. Let your power come our way, each one of us. Oh, yes, minister to us, Father. By your spirit and by your glory. Even in the name of Jesus. Oh, Lord, we thank you. Oh, Lord, we praise you. Yes, we magnify you, our Lord, because you are the King of glory. We give thanks and praise to you. Our heart rejoices because of what you have been able to do. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We honor you, Lord. Yes, and amen. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Father, Lord, we thank you once again this morning. This beautiful day that you have made for us to rejoice and be glad. Lord, we are grateful for all you've done in the course of the week. For the testimonies you've given to us. For the transformation. For your power that we have encountered. For your glory that has preserved us. Father, we thank you indeed. This week you have been our refuge. As always, you have been our fortress, our hiding place. Father, we thank you for the testimony that we have. Your protection and provision. Your eye that watches over us. For our going out and our coming in, we say thank you, Lord. For provision, we say thank you. For the gift of health, we say thank you. For the gift of healing, we say thank you. For the hope we have in you, we say thank you. For the privilege to access your presence, we say thank you. For the families you have given to us, we say thank you. This morning, Lord, we look up unto you, Lord. We know your presence is here, we can feel you. Father, minister to each one of us. For everyone that are watching, minister to them as well. Glorify yourself in our lives together. Blessed be your name forevermore. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. And children of God, see you.
Amen.
Give the Lord a shout of praise this morning. Hallelujah. Yes, God will praise. You are the God of glory. Amen. Hallelujah. The word of the Lord says, and we enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his court with praise. It's time for us to praise the Lord. Let's put on our dancing shoes as we worship in His presence. Hallelujah. Are you ready to praise the Lord?
Yes.
Church, are you ready to praise the Lord?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Let's go.
Yeah.
Just lift up your hands and worship this morning. Just give him praise. Our God is faithful. And he's merciful and compassionate.
Thank you.
There is no one. Our strength you are, our refuge you are, our protector, the love of our soul. Father, we thank you for all you've done. We thank you for what you are doing and for what you will do. This morning we surrender it all at your feet. Have your way in our lives. Take your place upon the throne of our soul. Be Lord, be King of our lives. Manifest yourself in the midst of your people. For unto you we are gathered today. Thank you, Father, for the testimonies that await us. In Jesus' name we worship.
Amen.
And the people of God say,
amen.
Put your hands together for Jesus with me. Yes, amen. Let you receive in his presence as we take the announcement. Into the service today. I want to thank all our online followers. May the Lord bless you as He blesses us in the service today, in Jesus' name. I will request that we be upstanding as we take the Bible reading for today. As is our norm, when we take the Bible reading, we remain standing. We are reading from the book of 1 Peter chapter 5 and verse number 8. I don't want to read from here, from the Amplified Bible, but open whatever you have there as we read together. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse number 8. Are you there already? Say amen.
Amen.
Okay, I read from here, 1 Peter 5, 8. The Bible says, be well balanced. Be well balanced. Temperate, sober of mind. Be vigilant and cautious at all times. For that enemy of yours, the devil, roams around like a lion, roaring in fierce hunger, seeking someone to seize upon and devour. Hallelujah.
Yes,
the Bible is saying here that each one of us, we should be well balanced. That is in knowledge. Balance in what? In knowledge. Have understanding of what is going on around you and within your environment. Be well balanced. He said, be temperate. Be temperate, sober of mind. That is, you cannot be drunk with the affairs of the world. You need to be focused. That's what the Bible is saying. It says, be vigilant. That is, be watchful. Be cautious that you have an enemy who is ready to pounce at your time of ignorance. Hallelujah, somebody. And he mentioned the name of your enemy, the devil. He says, he roams around like a lion, roaring in fierce hunger, seeking someone to seize upon and devour. Hallelujah. May you not fall as a prey to the enemy in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let's take our seat in his presence. This morning, by the grace of the Lord, like you know, we are speaking on a subject titled Dealing with Territorial Strongholds. Say with me, territorial.
Territorial.
Yeah, we are dealing with territorial strongholds. And that is what we want to look at this morning. And as we begin this message today, I want you to wrap your mind around the events of the world. I want to take you back to your village. I want to take you back to where? I want to take you back to your village. I want to take you back to the places where you grew up. I want to take you back to the places where you went to school. I want to take you back to the places where some of you got married and where some of you have related. I want to take you back to the place where your mother conceived you and gave birth to you, where you grew up from. I want to take you back there this morning. Hallelujah. I want you to begin to picture the surroundings of your village, of your city, of your neighborhood those days. I want you to look at the level of development or the lack of it. Amen.
Amen.
There are things responsible for that. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Many times we ignorantly blame our politicians for lack of development, and we call them thieves, isn't it? Like in Kenya, we call them MPs because they think they're just going there to get fat. But there are things responsible for their inactions. Hallelujah. And these are the things we want to look at today. When you cannot deal with the source of a problem, you cannot take care of that problem. A lot of people on earth today, what they do is they are taking care of the symptom of the problem. The symptom of the problem is what we see when our politicians are unable to do what they are supposed to do. But their inability to perform is not our problem. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Our problem is deeper than that. Praise the name of the Lord. Inability of people to break through easily in their choice of calling and profession is as a result of these powers we want to talk about. Hallelujah.
Praise.
And this morning, I'm believing the Lord that today the Lord will break us free.
Amen.
From the clutches of territorial powers in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah, somebody.
Praise God.
Lift up your hand and shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout out loud hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There are spiritual forces and controlling powers that sit over territories. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
These spiritual powers and forces, they are in charge of the affairs of these territories. These powers, they rule in different regions of the world. And by way of explanation, what is a territory? A territory is an area of land under the jurisdiction of a ruler or state. Hallelujah. Take note, two distinct words. A territory is a land under the jurisdiction of a ruler or state. A ruler will be maybe a monarch, you understand? Or an emir. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Or a mayor. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
And state will be the national government of any nation. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Which means that a jurisdiction can be under a ruler and not be under the state. Just like the Queen of England has authority over the Prime Minister of England. She's a ruler as a monarch. Hallelujah. And the Prime Minister will have to consult with her to take certain decision about the affairs of the nation. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Are we together?
Yes.
So a territory is a landmass. It's a landmass. And you can discover with me that your village is situated on a land, through a verse, in a location, in a particular place. Hallelujah. Some of you don't even know who is ruling your village, but you know your chief and your sub-chief, isn't it?
Yes.
But they are not actually in charge of the affairs of that place. Those are just peripheral leaders. Those are just paper tigers. They are who? The real rulers are unseen. The real rulers are what?
Unseen.
There are also spiritual territories, and there are physical territories. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Like in Kenya, there are places called kayas. How many of you have heard about it? And each of your communities have your kayas. I know when you hear the word kaya, you think so much about the coast, isn't it? But even you in Luyala, in Nuna, you have your own shrine, you may not call it kaya. Hallelujah! That is where the forces of darkness in charge of the affairs of your nation empower the wicked of this world to take charge over your destiny. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So there are physical territories referred to as landmass. As what?
Landmass.
And there are different divisions in each territory. There are different what? Divisions. And this division, probably you might be wondering, maybe Kitengela East or Kitengela South. No, that is not the division. The division in each territory will be the health sector, the commerce, the banking, the industry, the oil and gas. These powers are in charge of everything that makes a nation tick. Hallelujah. Inasmuch as there are physical territories, there is the territory of the commerce and the economy of each nation of the world that these powers are sitting on. They determine who becomes millionaire and when. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Now listen to me. I know somebody will tell me, but the Bible says that you are the one who gives you the power to get wealth. Yes, but God knows that these forces are in charge of this territory. And they can do nothing about what they will do to you if you don't take charge of your own destiny in your hands.
Amen.
Hallelujah, somebody.
Praise God.
So don't give me that look. Papa, what are you trying to say? The Bible says you are in the world, but you are not of the world. Hallelujah. And Jesus said in the world you will see tribulation. He said, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. You need to understand how to plug in into the grace of God that delivers from these material powers. And you cannot fight these powers if you don't identify their pattern. You can't find them if you don't do what? And many of us, we have identified their patterns, but we are ignorant because we consider their pattern to be normal. Hallelujah. It's happening to James, and James is my neighbor. It's happening to Florence, and Florence is my twin sister. So if it's happening to me, no problem. No. You need to rise up and deliver yourself. Say, help me, Lord.
Help me, Lord.
These territorial powers are strongholds. They are powers and they control the mind of men and the mind of women in whatever territory they sit in. They influence the culture of each location. These powers control the commerce, I just mentioned that, and the economic situation of these territories they sit over. They control the politics. They do what? They control the politics and the policies of different nations and direct the affairs of organizations and the territory they sit upon. People that God has created in this country that are under the influence of these forces, we can see them. All these our legislators from Rift Valley, some from Western, hallelujah, The others from Nyanza. Amen. From the coast. Human beings who have intelligence, but their brains have drained out. Because when they open their mouth to speak, you ask yourself, if they live in the same country as us, it's not their fault. The territorial powers have sapped them of wisdom. Hallelujah. He's now in charge of what they say. They don't care to throw the country into war because of their own selfish gain. Amen?
Amen.
It's not their fault. It is the powers of darkness speaking through them. And today, the Lord will deliver this nation from such people.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
They control the politics and influence the policies of different nations. And they direct the affairs of organizations. These forces control families and business empires. Hallelujah. That is why you can see today, many of you have been introduced to drug without knowing it. Hallelujah. Some of the biscuits that you buy are laced with cocaine and heroin. Some of the sweets you buy are laced with bangies and with steroids. Hallelujah. Because somebody somewhere just wanted to do what the devil wanted to do. He opens a company, he manufactures these things, but you cannot tell. And that is why sometimes you send your children to boarding school. When they come back, you discover they have changed. Hallelujah. Because the forces in the territory where their schools are located, we control the mind of everyone who is not spiritually sound there. Hallelujah. So they are in charge of the health ministries. Like coronavirus was not of God, but God permitted it for a purpose. It was manufactured in a laboratory. Hallelujah. Why? The devil wants to make somebody a millionaire through vaccines. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
And that is why we have been protected, because we belong to him. And he will continue to protect us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
They are in charge of the health ministries. Pharmaceutical companies are working for Satan. 90% of them. They are working for who? They are producing medications that will tune your mind to think about things that are contrary to the plan of God for you. Some drugs that are sold on the shelves are induced by the powers of demons. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
And they come with all kinds of names. And they call them symptoms. They created it. Hallelujah, somebody. They are in charge of the banking sectors. They control the oil and gas. And above all, they control the mind of men and make them to do things that are contrary to God's plan for their lives.
Amen.
These powers are referred to as territorial strongholds. They are strongholds because they have been here before your grandfathers were born. Hallelujah. They are in charge of the affairs of the nations. Only the nation that will pray will be delivered from such powers. Amen.
Amen.
They are the powers that operate from the dark places of the earth. They operate from what? The dark places of the earth. They are enabled by Lucifer. And they are very wicked. And they show no mercy. These powers are vicious. They show no mercy. This power sometimes influences the church of God in different nations of the earth. If the church is ignorant of the operations, you can see today the church in Kenya has gone to bed with the government. The church in Kenya is influenced by demons. Some pastors mistook me when they catch me, but I am covered. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
The church of God in Kenya is full of demoniacs because the territorial powers of East Africa is influencing the decision that the church makes. The church has gone to bed with the government that it is supposed to give guidance and direction to. Hallelujah! The church has become a laughing stock. Why? Because it has become ignorant of its purpose. And some ministers that you think have spiritual sight, they want to become presidents. When God has given the nation, you don't need to rule as a president to bring the will of God to a nation. Hallelujah. All you need to do is to stand in the place of your mandate. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And I'm going to tell you a very sad story this morning of somebody that is close to some of us. How these powers will target destiny and cut it off. God will prevent them from reaching you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So they influence our churches if we are ignorant of what they do. These powers are responsible for the outbreak of diseases. You understand? Diseases are manufactured. You have the outbreak of cholera. What breaks it out is not being dirty. Some demon have come to poo somewhere. You understand? Mm-hmm. Yeah, they have come to poo somewhere. Hallelujah. And they poo on the food that in the market. You understand? You see, sometimes people go to some very quality hotel and they eat, and a lot of them have cholera, isn't it? It is not that they are dirty there. Some demons went there overnight in the marketplace where those items were sold and they pulled on it. Hallelujah. I'm telling you reality, that's not a joke. Amen. It sounds funny, but it's true. Yeah, it's true.
Amen.
Hallelujah, somebody.
Praise God.
Sometimes you want to pray at night because you are not taking charge of the demons in the atmosphere. They come to you when you are trying to say, Father, in the name of Jesus. And they just come to you and they just say, and in that name, hallelujah. When the blow sleep on you, you just become a stone motion in the name of Jesus. And if this was to be your bed or your wall, you just see yourself going in the name of Jesus. Why? Because the territorial powers in your neighborhood know the damage you are going to do, so they blew you to sleep. Hallelujah. And when your power will not be effective, they allow you to wake up. And you say, in Jesus' name, amen. You say the grace, but you never prayed. Amen, somebody. And then you have seen the pattern, but you did not take it seriously. You assume you are tired. Hallelujah. That's how they influence people. They are responsible for the outbreak of diseases and plague in nations. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Listen, every hospital in different localities have these agents there. Hallelujah. Doctors that are demoniacs, nurses that are demoniacs, ward attendants that are demoniacs, you understand?
Amen.
Cleaners that are demoniacs. So everywhere you go, you have them. Because the devil has positioned them to do what? Target bright destinies and try to cut it out. But they will not reach you.
Amen.
I say they will not reach you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
They are also responsible for untimely deaths. You hear somebody had a baby, the money by night is gone. You hear somebody sleep and did not wake up. Hallelujah. You hear somebody has light fever and is gone. Amen.
Amen.
And nothing was wrong. And the people who, the postmortem could not say anything. They say they died of natural causes. No, it's not a natural cause. Somebody strangled him in the spirit.
Amen.
And he passed on because there is nobody praying for him. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
They are responsible for road accidents that maim people. They turn people to cripple. You understand? They are responsible for road accidents. They are responsible for addiction and substance abuse. You understand? Somebody will not just be able to control his alcohol intake. I mean, he really wants to stop. She really wants to stop. But they couldn't. Everything they do, one step forward, several step backward. Because the territorial forces of their village, you understand, as connived with the territorial forces of their present location. You understand? Because in the realm of the spirit, there is no entrance. You understand? They can reach you anywhere. Hallelujah. This morning we shall break their yoke down.
Amen.
And destroy their garrisons.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
These powers are responsible for the sexual perversion going on in the world. Where a man wants to sleep with a man, and a woman wants to sleep with a woman. If we mention that name now, Facebook will remove this video. So we will not mention that name. Hallelujah. If we say that, that's part of perversion. If we say who they are as they are called now, Facebook will fight for them. Hallelujah. They will say this content is offensive. Facebook, Facebook, Facebook. Hallelujah, somebody. Can you imagine? They have infiltrated every sector. The media, they are there. That is why you see that all the things that make news in the world all over is bad news. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Somebody asked me this morning if I listen to news. It's not wrong to listen, but I don't. Hallelujah. It's not wrong to listen because you need to know what is going on. But every time you open it, it's a wound with Israel and it's Ruto. It's our life before Baran knows play. Why should it be Ruto and Raila? Why not Papa? Hallelujah. Why not Gilbert? Why not Sharon? Do they have seven heads and we have only half? Hallelujah. So bad news. And if they are not talking of Uru, they are talking of one illiterate in caps at it. Hallelujah. Oh, another drunk in Kiambu. Katundu. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Or another ignoramus in Migori or whatever. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And then you feed yourself with those content. And then your blood is boiling for nothing. Let your blood boil for Christ.
Amen.
Not for politicians.
Amen.
Hallelujah, somebody.
Say,
help me, Lord. So they are responsible for these sexual perversions we see going on around. These powers are responsible mostly for the breakdown of marriages, okay? And destruction of family units. These powers are the ones responsible for high rate of depression and suicide that we see around the world today. Some of these territorial powers are so powerful that even angels dread them. Angels do what? Dread them. Hallelujah. So we are not talking about mean powers. They are so powerful that even angels dread them. Amen, somebody. These powers identify great destinies and they attempt to stop the destinies from seeing the light of the day. They try to do that with Jesus, isn't it? And God has to take him to hiding. They try to do that with Daniel more than once. They try to do that with Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego. They tried it with Moses. Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Today, every territorial power assigned to you will go blind in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let me hear a powerful amen.
Amen.
And you see these powers, they manipulate the mind of men. They do what? And they make men to act according to their will. I want to tell you this story of a young man who was the best student in Form 4 exam. You call it K? K what? I don't want chorus answer.
KCSE.
Is it right? KCSE. He was the best in 2012 national schools. Hallelujah. He's a brother to one of our dear sisters. He was the best. He got admission in Yale. When you go to Yale and you come back and you are a big person, he graduated. Hallelujah. And he did not find where to go but Migori. And by now he's dead. We are burying him on Friday. Hallelujah. They cannot tell who killed him. A bright student with a future. Hallelujah. The territorial powers of his father's house followed him to Yale, brought him back. I mean, why will he go to the village instead of seeking employment in Nairobi? He has sisters in Kitengela here. Hallelujah. Do you understand? But his life has been snatched away. Territorial powers. Hallelujah. And if you look at his Facebook post, you will see the sign. But the father, and most of the family are born again Christian, but they could not read the pattern of territorial powers. They cut off destinies. Women in this family are brilliant, but never married for long. Hallelujah. Men are very exceptional, but never breakthrough. Everybody goes back home at the end of the day. And the one that refused to go back wanders around, cannot make ends meet. Talented people, anointed people. Men that when they sit down, you sit under the administration, you will feel heaven. But that grace is not helping them. Hallelujah. Because it's a different thing for God to use you. It's another thing for you to be delivered. From a covenant that is operational in your bloodline that you have refused to do something about. Are we together? So these are vicious powers. They are operating there and right everywhere. They allow people to have what they need, but they will not allow people to enjoy the blessing of what they have. Territorial power. Hallelujah. They are in charge of everything around them, around the world. How do these powers operate? They take charge of the mind of men and manipulate your thoughts and imagination. How do they operate? They take charge of the mind of men. Men now is generic, men and women, and they manipulate your thoughts and imagination. That's how they operate. For example, there are places in the world where development and civilization have never been as embraced. Can you believe that? I remember many years back we went to a place called Coma Hill in Jos, where we found people who are naked, they only have leaves around them. They spark fire with rock, you understand? And they don't have salt. They have some particular leaf that tastes like salt that they use. They refuse civilization. Every time situation is coming to them, they keep moving until they went to the mountains. You will climb the mountain 3 hours before you reach them. So how are you going to take road to those ones? How are you going to go and build hospital there? Hallelujah. Why? The devil blinded the mind of the leaders of the community not to allow modernization so that they can kill children through childbirth. Hallelujah. The mortality rate there is very high. People are dying of common cold. Why? Because modernization that we give them common understanding, the devil blinded their mind to see it. So the power sitting on their territory has refused modernization. Hallelujah. Amen. And there are many places like that around the world. They do things in the primitive way. Hallelujah. I mean, they stand in the way of modernization. If it is coming, they don't allow it. Women are dying because of lack of maternity care. People are dying from preventable and treatable diseases. Because these communities are still living in the stone age. Amen? Amen. This is the true power in charge has refused them to see the benefits of civilization. There are tribes in places like Papua New Guinea. Have you ever had that country before? Papua New Guinea.
Somebody say Papua New Guinea.
Hallelujah, somebody. There are tribes in countries like Papua New Guinea. They call them the holy wheat men. Men who put on wigs and they do everything. Some of them threw raw animals. Hallelujah. The Dongo of West Africa. Amen.
Amen.
Primitive. The Himba Hakas of Namibia. When those ones see civilization, they go more into the forest. The Bayaka people of Central African Republic, to mention but a few. There are numerous of such, we call these ones uncontacted people. We call them who? Uncontacted people. There are some of them in India and in Bangladesh, in Japan, and in part of Central America, where witchcraft is the order of the day, and people are living in abject poverty and under extreme conditions that you will not believe unless you see it with your eyes. These people are under satanic influence through territorial forces. Hallelujah. And don't look too far. Your village is also suffering the same. That is why your people have not seen much development. It is not your governor who hates your tribe. Hallelujah. It is the territorial power that has influenced his mind to punish you. You get the point? Yeah. Some of you see the water you drink in the village is not pure, isn't it? Some of you still bathe with those water that looks like chocolate, right? The water is so brown. Amen? In your village. You still go to the stream in this age to fetch water. And sometimes you visit the village, you feel good that it's a long time I've come to the stream. Territorial forces doing something to you. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
You shake your job, you go to the village, you go in with the street girls, and they say, hey, how? Sasa, poor. Territorial power doing something to you. Hallelujah. Anytime you get there, what you are supposed to do is to identify that pattern and break that slow development. But no, you are used to it. Do something. Hallelujah. Your grandmother still cooks with 3 stones. You say, no, mom does not like to eat food. Buy her the gas first. And find out when she's tired if she will not cook with it. Hallelujah. Your mother still lives in a mud house. You say these people don't like modern houses, says who? Your toilet are still outside you today at this beach. This century. And then you go home, you sit down there, you do your business. Hallelujah. And the demons play on down your head, yes. Well done, man. And then you come out, you feel good. You say, Amen. Territorial powers at work. These are the patterns, but you never know why they have manipulated the mind of men to think that it is normal. Hallelujah. Till the Maisha.
Praise.
Yes. Hallelujah. Praise God. Yes. Hallelujah. Are we together?
Yes.
These are forces you need to rise up against. You need to do what? Rise up against it. Hallelujah. Because these powers have brought bondage and pain to your community. Haven't you seen in this kind of community insects go on unreported? True of us. Uncles sleeping with their cousins and nephews and nieces. You understand? Aunties molesting young boys. And because of the family name, they keep it. Why? Because there is no development. Amen, somebody?
Amen.
Some of you never see police station until you come to town, isn't it? No police post. Some of you don't have hospitals until you walk kilometers. and then you go, you do something to the stream. And you say this stream water is cold, it's good, it's good. Who told you it is good? Hallelujah. It's different from the Nairobi water. Amen.
Amen.
Help me, God.
Help
me, Lord. Your grandmother is still cooking with this stream. Repent. And pray that God will break that yoke over that family.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The lack of development you see in your village and constituency. Not these powers. Amen.
Amen.
Not because your politicians are thieves. It's because the temporary powers in charge has blinded their mind to do the right thing. Some of the lack of breakthrough you experience in your own life, you know, is as a result of the operation of this power. Today, God will deliver you from their clutches in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I say God will deliver you.
Amen.
There are powers that sit over the control of your village. You understand? That dictates what goes on there. And when you look at your village, you look at the pattern that the men are always under the tree, playing draft. It's a pattern. Able-bodied men in the morning, they go under the tree, they are playing games, you understand? Or they are drinking brood. That is the local brew. You understand? From morning to evening, under the tree, and they are gossiping. Men, the women are the ones who go to labor. Then there is a curse under that, that family. I mean that neighborhood. Those are the signs. You go home, you see them, hey, Shasa, or whatever you speak. You understand? It's a pattern. They make men to be irresponsible. And when you come to the city as their sons, you become also like that if you are not careful. You'll not be able to pass in there and break through. You want to become lazy. You understand? Because your fathers are irresponsible, and the forces of darkness ruling in your village. They also have the extension here in the city. Say, help me now. So they are in control of your village. They sit over the control of your city, your county, sub-county, your district, constituencies, locations and sub-locations. These powers determine what goes on in the places under their control. Amen.
Amen.
These powers have one mission. Identify any destiny that is a threat to their kingdom and cut it off. They don't want anyone to be a voice for God. Amen, somebody. And unfortunately, Kenya, we are in big trouble. We are what? Look at all the established churches in this nation. None of them is speaking for us as believers. The Muslims have people who speak for them. The Hindus have people who speak for them. Recognize leaders that they respect. Who is a leader in the Church of Kenya who is respected without blemish? Tell me one. There are people without blemish, but are they leaders? Hallelujah, somebody. Why? The territorial powers have taken possession of the nation. And we need to break that yoke today in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We need to break that yoke today in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Because these powers have only one mission. Identify destinies that address the kingdom they represent and cut it off. For example, let's go to the book of Daniel chapter 10. Daniel chapter 10. Are we together this morning, people?
Amen.
Daniel chapter 10. And we look at verse 12 to 20. Daniel 10. I read from the New King James Version. Daniel 10. Remember, we are talking about territorial strongholds. Then he said to me, Daniel 10, 12 now. Then he said to me, do not fear, Daniel. For from the first day that you set your heart to understand and to humble yourself before your God, your words were heard. Your words were? And I have come because of your words. Now listen, Daniel started to pray and fast because he understood in chapter 9 by the books the number of years that Israel should be bonded. Remember, Israel is a people in a territory that needed to return back to their own territory. Hallelujah! So Daniel needed to know, when are we supposed to be free? He started to make inquiries in prayers. And this angel was sent to him. And this angel could not reach him. This angel told him when he finally came and said, from the very first day you started to pray, your voice was heard, and I was sent to you. Hallelujah! The angel was not even ashamed. He said this, but the prince of the kingdom of Persia withstood me out 20 and 1 days. And behold, Michael, one of the chief princes, came to help me, for having left alone there with the king of Persia. That is an angel from the presence of who? Delayed. That is called kidnap, isn't it? He was snatched against his will by the power in charge of the territory where Daniel lives. Hallelujah. Do you now understand what we are saying? This guy was coming from the presence of God, but he does not have what it takes to control, to confront that demon. So he was arrested. He had no permit to cross. Hallelujah. They asked him, where is your entry permit in Tobasia? He didn't know what to say. So he was arrested and relayed. But thank God for Daniel, he never stopped praying, like many of you we do. He kept on praying, and on the 21st day, God had no choice. I said, Michael, go help that ignoramus angel and bring him back here safely. Hallelujah. And Michael came and said, oh boy, what's your problem? So you don't know the principle of what we are still now. Hallelujah.
Praise
God. Say, God help me.
God help me.
If your angels are weak, heaven will change them today.
Amen.
What kind of amen is that?
Amen.
I said, if your angels are weak, heaven will change them today.
Amen.
Because this angel showed me that there are weak angels. He's observing situations. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
So this man said, the prince of Persia will lead him. Now I have come to make you understand. Did you get that? I have come to make you understand. It means that when there is no certain breakthrough in certain areas of spiritual matters, you will not understand how to enter into your breakthrough. Hallelujah, somebody. Now I have come to make you understand what will happen to your people in the latter days. For the vision will last for many days yet to come. He was seeking an understanding so that they can have knowledge of how to plan for their own deliverance. Hallelujah. But the angel was relayed. Amen, somebody. And then, blah, 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 they kept saying that. And then, in verse 19, he said to Daniel, O man greatly loved, fear not, peace be to you, be strong. Yes, be strong. For when he spoke to me, I was strengthened and said, let my Lord speak, for you have strengthened me. Then he said, listen to this. Do you know why I have come to you? And now I must return to fight with the prince of Persia. Now, Michael has given him power. So what happened? He was released to come and deliver a message to Daniel, but the battle was yet undone. Amen, somebody. He said, now I must return to do what? To fight with the prince of Persia. And when I have gone forth indeed, the prince of Greece will come. Hallelujah. So Persia has a demonic prince. Greece has a demonic prince. Kenya has a demonic prince. East Africa has a demonic prince. Hallelujah. Africa as a whole, as a continent, has a demonic prince. Amen.
Amen.
King Angela has a demonic prince. Your neighborhood has a demonic
prince.
You see what you are fighting against and you sleep. I open your mouth. Amen.
Amen.
When you are supposed to be praying like Daniel, you are sleeping. Sometimes those plants that are trying to enter, they might be demons. Amen. Say, help me, Lord.
Help me, Lord.
Tell your neighbor, this is serious matter.
This is serious matter.
Tell him, wake up. Hallelujah, somebody. So from this reading, you will see that each territory has a powerful demon controlling it. And they are called princes. Amen, somebody. And these powers can stop God's purpose for anyone's life. If you don't take charge of your territory. You understand?
Amen.
If you don't dislodge them, they will stop the purpose of God for your life. And God will not do anything about it. Because he has given you the authority to understand and to dislodge them. Say, God, help me to dislodge them.
God, help me to dislodge them.
In 2 Corinthians 10:4, what did we see there? 2 Corinthians 10:4. The Bible says, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but I'm reading here, from the Amplified. See, for the weapons of our warfare are not physical, and that's the meaning of carnal. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. They are mighty before God for the overthrow and destruction of strongholds. Amen?
Amen.
So the weapons of our warfare, they are not physical, they are not carnal, they are mighty before God, and they have the power to overthrow and destroy strongholds. Hallelujah. Now, how do you understand this power can work for you? You need to catch a revelation of the God who promised. Daniel knew what was going to happen. He said, I understood by the books. I understood by the books. Hallelujah. That books he's talking about is the Torah. Hallelujah. The words of God through the prophets that have gone before him. Many of us don't have our deliverance delivered because we lack spiritual information and spiritual insight. Hallelujah. And we wallow in the same problem because we lack the knowledge of how to fight. There is power available to you. Yeah. All you need to do is to catch the revelation of it and walk with that power, and deliverance will be your portion. Yes. No power has the authority to hold you down unless you allow it. Hallelujah, somebody. So the weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal. They have the ability to dislodge. Say, today I will dislodge them. Say, today I will dislodge them. Every territorial power assigned against my destiny, I will dislodge them today in the name of Jesus. Amen, somebody. Daniel identified it and he confronted it. David knew what was going on with Goliath. And he confronted him. Amen, somebody. Amen. Abraham could not prosper. Abraham could not be with a child. Because the territory where he is where people have been barren for years. And God said, I cannot help you here because the powers here, they have authority to rule here. Nobody is looking at me here. But I will take you to a place I will sacrifice for you. And then I will bless you. Hallelujah, somebody. I pray for you today. The Lord will open your eyes to see. So you can display those powers. In the name of Jesus. If the Lord will relocate you, he will do that this morning. In the name of Jesus. And when Abraham left, he carried that territory with him. He went with Lot. And heaven could not speak to him. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Until Lot separated himself from Abraham, then God began to speak it. We are dealing with powers that are shrewd. They are what? And how do I put it? The Bible said the serpent was what? Cunning. Very cunning powers. Hallelujah.
Amen.
These are the powers we are dealing with. They bring conflict with marriages. And then you will blame each other. Not knowing the devil is the one fighting you. Hallelujah. They impose bad habits on your children.
Yes.
You will be killing them. The Bible says the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. They are not carnal. They are not carnal. Get understanding. Get a revelation about where you are and where you are. And the breakthrough will come without any hindrance.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
See, open my eyes to see me.
Open my eyes to see me.
So how do you dislodge these territorial struggles? Number one, how do you dispose them? Identify that they are there. That's the first thing. You must be aware. Claim yourself to me. You must be aware they are there. Hallelujah, somebody.
Praise God.
You must be aware they are there. Do not behave as if they are not there. And that's how many of us will behave. Jesus. Identify there. They're there. The Bible talks about we have a cloud of witnesses. These are the saints of God who have gone ahead. And there are also a cloud of witnesses from the devil who are planning to hinder us from achieving our destiny. They will not succeed over you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now, after you identify they are there, number two, stand up for your territory in prayers. And intercessions. Dismantle their evil network in prayers and intercessions. After you have identified they are there, stand up for your territories in prayers and intercession. Dismantle the evil networks of these territorial strongholds. That is the second. Number three, break every known covenant pattern. Every known covenant pattern. When you begin to notice something in your village, amen? Like I told you, if your grandmother is still cooking with three stones, in this age, if you are still traveling to the stream in your village to go and get water, that is a pattern of struggle. That is a pattern of what? Struggle. Break that pattern in the name of Jesus. You will be surprised as you are breaking that pattern here, something will begin to happen at home. Are we together?
Yes.
Don't say ni maisha. Ah, si maisha. Ni kimani. Hallelujah, somebody. It's not maisha at all. Because God break the known covenant pattern, which you have noticed. Break it. Then number four, disconnect yourself from the influence of these forces by commanding your day before you leave your house. So it's a daily battle that you fight. Disconnect yourself from what? The influence of these forces by commanding your day before leaving your house. Hallelujah. That is the fourth thing you do to deal with these powers. Thank you, Jesus.
Demons tremble at your presence. What a mighty God.
Everything written about you is great.
power assigned against my life and my destiny. Today, I arrest you and I break your link over my life in the name of Jesus. Clap your hands and pray.
This morning I arrest them. this morning I arrest any demonic power working against your marriage, working against your health, working against your business, working against your ministry, working against your calling, working against your career, working against your profession, working against your happiness. This morning I arrest them in the name of Jesus, and I break their link over your life.
Thursday at 5:40 p.m. Have a wonderful Sunday ahead of you.